Hello everyone and welcome back. I am your host, Elias Sarantopoulos. In this Affinity Designer for iPad tutorial, you will learn how to add a layer mask and use that to hide portions of a layer and reveal contents below. We will use black and white color to see the effects of layer masking, as well as using a gradient to control transparency and work non-destructively. All that in your iPad with Affinity Designer. And so, inside Affinity Designer, I have opened up a document with a bunch of horizontal lines, a file that I am providing for you below the video description if you wish to follow along. Okay, so I'm going to tap on the Layer Studio and I'm going to toggle off the visibility of these horizontal lines. And let's go ahead and type a word here. So I'm going to tap on the Artistic Text Tool. Just going to type mask. As you can see, I'm using a bold typeface. I'm going to center this, and at the same time, I'm going to increase the stroke width here. So under the Stroke Studio, just bring up the width a bit, like so. And under the Advanced Options and under the Align, tap on the Center Alignment. Okay. All right. Now, I know that I'm going to be using this mask layer again at the near future. So I'm just going to tap on the edit menu and duplicate that layer. Okay. All right. Now we need to actually separate the fill from the stroke. So we're going to tap on the edit menu again and then tap on the convert to curves option. And if you look inside the group, now we have four vector curves. So target those, select those, then tap back on the edit menu and then tap on the expand stroke option. As you can see, we have curves with only the stroke and curves with only fill. Now I'm going to group those curves. So tap on the group icon and then just target the curves with just the fill and group those as well. At this point, I'm just going to rename those. So under the layer options, rename this to stroke, if you wish. And then on this other group, I'm going to rename this to fill, like so. Okay, and one more thing I would like to do is actually take those two groups outside the group itself. So select those two, tap and hold, and bring those outside the group. So we are more flexible. So if this group is empty, you can just delete that. And for the next part, we're going to actually start adding some layer masks. For this next step, the goal is to use this shape layer as a mask over the horizontal lines, which will be cropped to that shape's outline. So in other words, those horizontal lines will be inside the word mask and specifically inside the fill part. Now, a layer mask allows us to control a layer's level of transparency. And we are masking based on color, which means black color conceals, white color reveals. In other words, white color in a layer mask means 100% visible, and black color in a layer mask means 100% transparent. So let me go ahead and demonstrate this for you. So I'm going to target this fill layer, and instead of red, I'm going to use black color, and then I'm going to add a layer mask to it. So tap on the merge and rasterize icon. At the bottom of the list, we have this option, the rasterize to mask option. That will rasterize the selected vector layer as a mask layer. So tap on that, and now we have a layer mask. Now, whichever layer is beneath the layer mask, in this case, those horizontal lines, they will be cropped to the masked layer. So go ahead and toggle on the visibility of those horizontal lines. And as you can see, we cannot see anything. And that's because the fill layer was filled with black color, and black color hides contents inside a mask. So we're going to undo this and change the color from black to white. Add a layer mask, and then toggle on the visibility of those horizontal lines. As you can see, because we used white color for the layer, It means 100% visible, which shows contents inside a layer mask. Another idea here is to actually add another layer mask and make this a bit more interesting. So I'm going to target the first layer. I'm going to make a duplicate out of it because I will probably need it down the road. And then I'm going to tap and hold to bring this all the way at the bottom of the layer stack, like so. Now what you see is very normal because we have a layer mask, so whatever is underneath shows up. But for the moment, let me go ahead and tap on these horizontal lines. And with the Move tool, I'm just going to rotate slightly, like so. And then instead of a black stroke, I can actually use another color. Just make sure that you have the group stroke is also active. And then for this bottom layer, I'm going to make another duplicate. And for this one, I'm going to change its color. Well, you guessed it. Instead of red, white, because I'm going to add a layer mask to it. So tap on the merge and rasterize icon and use the rasterize to mask option. And now we have a layer mask. Now I would like to blend that layer mask with the text layer below using partial transparency represented by various shades of gray. So for that, I'm going to show you something new. I'm going to use the fill tool and I'm going to tap and drag to create a gradient. Now this gradient right now has two stops. I'm going to add one more right in the center. And that one will have a black color, which means it will hide the contents of the mask. And as for the other ones, we'll have a white color, like so. Okay. All right, now what I want to do is actually group all those layers, but the top one. I'm going to show you why. First, I'm going to group them. I'm going to deselect. And then I'm going to add a background. But if I add a background to this group, it will actually be clipped inside the mask. So that's why I had to go outside that group. So tap and drag, like so. Just change the color. And then tap and hold and bring this at the very bottom of the stack. Okay. Which in this case, I'm going to select those two and actually lock them because I don't want to move them accidentally. As for this one, the extra layer I have here, I'm going to tap and drag this, tap and hold and drag it in between those two layers. Okay. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually slightly offset it. No need for stroke. Okay. Just bring the text a bit closer. And perhaps we can use a shadow on the outside. So go to the Layer FX Studio and add an arrow shadow. And I can set its opacity to 100, let's say. And I can actually drag this around and position it interactively. Layer masks offer great control over transparency to hide portions of a layer and reveal layers below. They open doors to creative projects and possibilities by working non-destructively. Thank you for spending time with me. Let me know if you have any questions below the comments section. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel and share the knowledge.